Welcome again this week, folks. And I'm talking about really good news. News that doesn't always make the media in Queensland. And that's the great financial performance of local government over the last 4 years. When we're talking debt, and we all know how much debt the state and federal governments have, local government's debt's actually reduced by 16% over the last 4 or 5 years to $6.8 billion. Indeed, if we look at what we call net debt, that's debt over cash councils hold, the figure's a low $500 million. The asset base in Queensland, the assets that you councils own and operate on behalf of your communities, is a staggering $150 billion. When we talk about the council workforce, and bearing in mind that Queensland has grown by 18.5%, 800 odd thousand people over the last 10 years, and during that time, the local government workforce is still at 2008 levels of employment. Indeed, from 2011 through to 2019, our numbers have reduced by 4,500. Again, that contrasts very well with other levels of government. And on the most important issue for ratepayers, the hip pocket issue, councils through this term have been very modest with their rate increases. When we look across the local government horizon, we can see most councils are at or below CPI. Some years it's a little bit higher, more work has to be done, but they're very modest increases and ones that the community by and large can afford. Local government is an unsung hero when it comes to fiscal responsibility. We're doing it, not just talking about it. And bearing in mind, councils have no access to a growth tax. We don't have a growth tax like the payroll tax or indeed the GST or other forms of federal taxation. As we all know, councils' rate in the dollar on valuations fluctuates with changes. And as I say, we're only really raising about CPI every year in terms of the additional income that comes into the system. But the really telling figure, I guess, is that local government, with only 3% of total taxation in this country, has to fund 33% of the nation's infrastructure. That's extraordinary. Just think of 150,000 kilometres of council-owned road alone, and you get the picture. But local government's up to the challenge. I can assure you that hip pocket issues will not be to the fore in the 2020 elections, because councils have done such a great job on debt, workforce and rates. Well done to the councils of Queensland.